Hey, welcome to The Typical Guy. Today we're going to be using these guns to shoot this spray paint to make modern art with different calibers. Stay tuned to the end to see what it looks like and to see what our next gun video will involve. All right, here's the rounds we're gonna be using today. We're gonna start off with a 22 short, then a 22 long rifle hollow tip, a 38 special full metal jacket, a 357 hollow point, a 45 full metal jacket, a 45 hollow point, the 556 full metal jacket, 7mm full metal jacket, and then a shotgun slug. They should all give different explosions and make different art, so we'll see what happens. All right, we're going to start off with the 22 pistol with a 22 short round in it. This is going to be our smallest gun. Let's see what happens. Alright, you can see one nice little entry, one nice little exit wound, and so not a very big hole. You can see that it did a nice little splatter there. So next we're going to move to the rifle 22. Alright, next we move on to the 22 long rifle with a 22 rifle. Let's see what happens. All right, it looks pretty much the same as the 22 short. Nice little entry, nice little exit. Seemed to get it on the other side. It must have popped it out and blew everything on the other side over there. But on to the next round. All right, next we move to the Smith & Wesson 357. We have a 38 special round in there. Let's see what happens here. All right, here's our 22. There's our 357 38 special round in there. And you can see a little bit bigger of a round, but still made a mess. Let's go on to our next gun. All right, the Smith & Wesson 357 with the actual 357 Magnum round in it. Let's see what happens here. Oh, and a hollow point. All right, you can see the difference between a hollow point. There's your entry, and it just blew out the back. There is your, that's the 38 special, a little bit less powder in there, but still, I mean, it's pretty close to the same round. And there's the difference between the hollow point and just a full metal jacket. Pretty cool, right? All right, we're gonna move on to the Colt 45. I have a full metal jacket in there. It is going to be a little bit of a larger hole than what the 357 was, but this is not the hollow point, so it's not going to blow out the back. Let's see what happens. Here's our entry. Here's our exit, but you can definitely see a bigger round. Look at how small that one is. That's the 38 special. There is the 45. So now we move on to the 45 with the hollow point. All right, we got the Colt 45 with the hollow point. Let's see if it blows out the back of it. All right, 45 hollow point. Cut it in half. Oh, look at that. It's almost like perfectly round. The bottom part went on the other side. Both of them flew. I don't know how high. We didn't see how high they went, but it landed all the way over here. It's like 20 yards away from the where the target was. I mean, it just blew it apart. That was pretty cool. You can see your entrance, but then it went in and blew it all apart. All right. Well, we'll move on to the next round. All right, we're moving on to the AR-15 with a full metal jacket. Should just go straight through it. Should still have a lot of energy. So let's see what the AR-15 does. All right, so it didn't move it off the board. It stayed up there, but that's because I barely cut the edge of it. So you can see where it blew out the side. So that's pretty cool. But if I would have hit it in the middle, it would have went straight through. Oh, check that out. It kind of bent it up underneath there somehow. But yeah, so it made a good mess with the red. All right, on to the 7mm Magnum. All right, we're on to the 7mm Magnum. This is going to be our fastest, our biggest, not the thickest round, because that's going to be the shotgun slug, but it's going to be a big round going through really fast. Let's see what it does. All right, the can disintegrated. I wasn't expecting it to quite do that. I was maybe expecting like the AR-15 just to kind of pass through it, but here's our biggest piece that we could find. It just blew it out. There's little pieces of it all over the place. So still pretty cool. That was definitely a powerful shot. So now you see what a 7mm Magnum will do to a spray paint can. All right, here we go with the 12-gauge slug. This is the grand finale. Should make a good mess. Here we go. All right, it just blew out our backboard. This is what it did to the spray paint can. It has a little bit of a top. Here's the biggest part here. And I mean, here's some parts of it over. Oh, that's just the cover, but it just went all over the place. You can see the back of our board. It's just blew it all into pieces. So we'll redo it. We'll get back again. But you can see our mess all over the place of all of our different rounds shooting. So we had fun. Hope you had fun. Our next video, we're going to be testing out planter boxes that you can put in front of your house to make your house bulletproof. And we're going to see how thick they need to be in order to stop different kinds of rounds. So, you know, you can see that 7mm Magnum was just traveling a whole lot faster than what your smaller rounds are. So, we'll see just how much dirt you need in front of your house, and you know, you can build it up about 3 feet high to keep your front room safe from bullets. So that's what we'll be testing our next gun video. So tune in with us. I hope that you subscribe, and thank you for watching.